We're here right now. This is the biggest transformation in history of the world. It's from industrial age to information age. And if you're standing in front of the mirror today, you know, with this coronavirus and looming depression, how did I get here is the question. What don't I know? What did my information, education, cultural background, what did not prepare me for today? That's where the transformation or the metamorphosis begins. We take responsibility. You know, everybody talks about rights, but we have personal responsibilities too. So this is how what Fuller talked about, the prison is inside our head, Buckminster Fuller. It starts with misinformation and misorientation. And he says, how dare our schools punish kids for making mistakes? How else do you learn if you don't make a mistake and learn from your mistake? He says, God designed us to learn by making mistakes. For instance, a baby learns to walk by falling down. So for many people, this corona crisis and the ensuing depression that we're going into is your wake-up call where you're going to be a victim and somebody's going to sip on you that the little worm you are because you didn't metamorphosize. You did transition from an immature form to a mature form.
Now, people are at home right now, and you buy into that mechanism of money, and you believe that that is the only thing to focus on. And what you're saying right now with these stimulus packages is all of this money being given, quote unquote, away by the government to everybody is actually devaluing your dollar. It's devaluing your pension, it's devaluing your savings, and it's wiping out businesses. You're dying by this sword. No, but you're right. I mean, this could be the greatest wake-up call for most of the citizens around the world. And look, from what we see with the numbers, you know, most people are gonna survive through this, but let's be honest, it also could have been worse. So the question is, are you gonna start making choices today about your health, you know, about your obesity, about your smoking, about your habits? Are you gonna start making choices today about your financial education? And are you gonna take ownership for where you're at right now? Unfortunately, everything you hear coming out of the media is preaching it's not your fault and the government's gonna take care of you, and that's just gonna set you up to be a slave, and then the next crisis is gonna hit and the next crisis is gonna hit. And again, I completely agree with you, Robert. This is perhaps one of the best chances in your entire life to literally be smacked into consciousness and say, wait a second, it's time I stop living in fear, take ownership of what's happening, and do, as you said, which is, what does God want you to do? And you explain this in a good way. And God, that is different than what you want to do. What you want to do for you is this selfish ego talking. What God wants you to do is what you're supposed to do for the greater good. And it sounds counterintuitive, but that choice always brings you financial prosperity, spiritual prosperity, and a great life.
A great life. A great life. A great life. A great life.